Now, we will discuss about AC generator, that is automatic current generator. This was developed by Nikola Tesla. Electromagnetic induction phenomena finds number of applications in physics. We know that without the power, nowadays life is impossible. Also, there are several devices which make use of electric motors. So, these electric motors and generators work on the principle of electromagnetic induction. The AC generator developed by Tesla, the main parts of which are shown here, it consists of a coil mounted on a shaft which rotates in a magnetic field. So, the axis of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field produced by two magnetic poles, permanent magnetic poles. Now, the ends of the coil are connected to slip rings so that the coil can rotate freely, so that the wires or the ends will not twist. The slip rings are connected to carbon bushes or graphite bushes from which the power is drawn. Now, we know the magnetic flux is given by BA into cos theta, where theta is the angle between the magnetic field and the area vector. Suppose if the position of the coil changes, the effective area cut by the coil changes. So the effective area of the coil that cuts the magnetic field changes. Therefore, an EMF will be induced because the flux changes. So this is the effective area that changes with the rotation of the coil. The energy required for rotation of the coil is provided by some external agent. Now, suppose if omega is the angular speed with which the coil rotates, and let n be the number of turns in the coil, and therefore the flux can be written as BAN cos omega t. So if the coil is initially, suppose if the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, then the flux is minimum. The area vector and magnetic field vector are in the same direction, either parallel or anti-parallel. Hence, the flux cut by the coil when it rotates is minimum. But when the coil is parallel, plane of the coil is parallel to the magnetic field, then for a small rotation, the flux cut by the coil will be maximum with the magnetic field. Hence, therefore, the induced EMF will be maximum. So, let us see that the induced EMF is given by from Faraday's law, d∅dt. So that is equal to minus. So B, A, N are constant, and the differential is for the cos function, cos omega t, and therefore this can be written as minus B, A, N omega. See, differential of cos theta is minus sin theta. Therefore, this minus of minus becomes 1 or plus. Therefore, this will be sin omega t. Therefore, BAN omega into sin omega t. This can be written as a maximum EMF into sin omega t, where the maximum value of induced EMF is BAN omega. So, since the sin omega t can take plus or minus 1 values, so in one rotation the induced EMF can become maximum once in positive direction and once in negative direction, that is in opposite direction. So this is a periodically changing function. Hence, the EMF induced or the current generated sinusoidally varies or periodically varies. Therefore, if you draw a graph between the period taken on, that is time taken on x-axis, and the induced EMF on y axis, you will get a sine curve like this. So you will be getting a sine curve like this. So when t is equal to say 0, the induced EMF is 0. So the EMF will be maximum. So that will be maximum for t by 4. And again it will be minimum for t by 2. And maximum again at 3t by 4. So but in opposite direction. So the graph bar between the time and EMF shows a sine curve which shows the EMF induced is periodically changing. So when the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic field, so the flux that passes the cut by the coil is minimum. Whereas it is parallel, when it just turns, the magnetic field lines cut by the coil will be maximum. So for every 90 degrees, you see the it is becoming maximum, and for another 90 degrees minimum, and for another 90 degrees maximum, like that. So for 90 degrees position and for 270 degrees position, the induced EMF will be maximum, and for other two positions it will be minimum. So that's why this generator is called as alternating generator, current generator, and EMF induced is called alternating EMF. So the external agent required to rotate the coil is provided by flowing water, such as the water stored in dams is allowed to pass through a tunnel like arrangement. So it comes very fast, that is kinetic energy coming into potential energy due to the kinetic energy. So water is used to rotate the coils, and this is how electricity is produced in hydroelectric power generation stations such as in Sri Sailam and Nagaswara in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. So we use this water stored in the dams in Sri Sailam and in Nagaswara, where the kinetic energy of the water flowing is used to rotate the turbines or the coils. Similarly, in thermal power stations, the heat energy generated by burning coal or other fuels is used to evaporate water, and with the pressure of water vapor is used to rotate the turbines. But in actual turbines, instead of rotating the coil, the magnets will be rotating and the coil will be stationary. So that is actually what will be seen in actual power generating stations. In the turbines, the magnets will be rotating around the coil, and the same effect takes place. The effective area cut by the coil is changing, hence the magnetic flux linkage with the coil changes, hence an EMF will be induced. So with this, electromagnetic induction chapter is over. But one point I want to tell you is a generator, AC power generator is inverse or converse of a motor, electric motor. In an electric motor, the mechanical energy is produced where the electrical energy is used. So electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy in electrical motors. In power generators, mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. So before completing this topic, I will show you a small experiment that is nothing but the working of an electric motor. So that is also based on the principle of electromagnetic induction, but here I am using only one coil, one tub, and a cell for supplying the current, and a magnet. So a current is passed through a coil which is in a magnetic field, so a torque acts on it and the coil rotates. So I will show you now. So that is a monopolar motor. So you can see the coil rotating. So this is the coil, and there is the cell, and here this is the magnet. So you can see that. So This is a one turn coil. It is pivoted here, and there is a magnet. This is the magnet, and a cell is attached to it. Now the current passes through this coil, and contacts are made at the positive terminal and at the negative terminal to the magnet. So as the current passes, and due to the magnetic field produced by this, a torque acts on the coil, and hence the coil rotates. So okay, so what you have seen is known as a monopolar motor. So a simple arrangement by which you can demonstrate the working principle of an electric motor. Okay, so with this, the electromagnetic induction chapter is completed, and that's about this. So though this is a small chapter, but very important from physics subject point of view.